Welcome to the next video in our series. Today I'm going to give you a simple demonstration of a really complex concept which will help one to perform in perfect rhythm. This concept is valuable not just for singers but also for instrumentalists, and it applies across the whole board for Western music as well as Indian music, whether it's Carnatic or Hindustani. Okay, to practice this, we need to first set our metronome. We can choose anywhere between 40 and 60 or even higher if you wish, but I've chosen 50 beats per minute. It's a good starting point. And you can hear the beats. And what we are trying to do is subdivide these intervals into equal divisions. So if you're dividing this time interval between two beats into three equal divisions, we call that tisram. If you're dividing it into four equal divisions, we call that chatusram. If you're dividing it into five equal divisions, we call that khandam. Into seven equal divisions, we call that mishram. And nine equal divisions, we call that sankirnam. Now, the second thing we need to understand is, when we divide these time intervals into three equal divisions or four equal divisions, and we're trying to sing that, we need to use some syllables. Of course, we can use words, numbers like 1, 2, 3 instead of syllables, but I would strongly recommend you stick to syllables if you want to go into more depth into this topic. So if you want to use, let's say, tisram, we need to use syllables, and the three syllables we use are ta, ki and ta. So ta, ki, ta, each of that is a syllable, or each of that we can also call this a matra. Matra means basically the smallest unit of the rhythm which you can fit into that space. So in tisragadi you will be the three units or three matras, so ta, ki and ta. If you are singing that in chatusragadi, we will be singing ta ka dhi mi, ta ka dhi mi, so that's the four matras. If you are singing it in khandagadi or five syllables, we will be using ta-ka-gi-na-to. Now these are not fixed syllables, but these are the commonly used syllables. Ta-ka-gi-na-to. Into seven or the misragadi, ta-ka-di-mi-ta-ki-da. Ta-ka-di-mi-ta-ki-ta. Seven. And sankirnam gadi is ta-ka-di-mi-ta-ka-gi-na-to. Ta-ka-di-mi-ta-ka-gi-na-to. Nine. So let's now practice the first one, which is the tisragadi. Takita, 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 takita. So I hope you could feel that. Takita, 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 ta, takita, ta. So you are dividing the interval into three equal divisions. So that's all what is what you need to do for singing tisragadi. If you want to sing it in chatusragadi, you want to divide that into four equal divisions. So takka dhimmi, 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 ta, takka dhimmi, ta, takka dhimmi, ta, takka dhimmi, takka dhimmi, takka dhimmi, takka dhimmi. So you can go on like that, and you can stop at times and just say ta, just to, so that you get that feeling. So make sure that you stick to the time intervals correctly. Now for singing the khandagadi or the five equal subdivisions, we use these syllables takaginatum, 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 ta, takaginatum, ta, takaginatum, ta, takaginatum, 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 ta. So we can divide that into five syllables. So practice each of these gadis individually. Now, if you want to practice the mishra gadi or the seven equal divisions, we use the syllables takadimi takida, 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 ta. தக்கதிமி தக்கிட்ட தக்கதிமி தக்கிட்ட தக்கதிமி தக்கிட்ட தக்கதிமி தக்கிட்ட தா. So like that, you can divide that into 7 divisions. And the final one is the Sankirna Gadi, where you are dividing that into 9 equal divisions. Takadimi takaginatum, takadimi takaginatum, takadimi takaginatum, takadimi takaginatum, ta. Takadimi takaginatum, takadimi takaginatum, takadimi takaginatum, ta. Takadimi takaginatum, takadimi takaginatum, takadimi takaginatum, ta. So divide that into 9 divisions. So each of these gadis practice individually, and if you're finding it really hard to stick to the syllables, you can use numbers. But as I said, it's better to practice with syllables for future lessons as well. Now I'll try and demonstrate switching between each of these gadis. So I will sing 4 of each gadi and move on to the next. Takitta, 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 takadimi, 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 takaginatum, 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 takadimi, takitta, takadimi, takitta, takadimi, takitta, takadimi, takitta, takadimi, takaginatum, takadimi, takaginatum, takadimi, takaginatum, takadimi, takaginatum, takadimi, takaginatum, takitta. So just to summarize and conclude, we learned about gadi, which is essentially a subdivision of the beat. We can subdivide the beat into equal intervals. We practiced 3, 4, 5, 7 and 9. We can subdivide them into other intervals as well, which we will go through later. We will go through many more complex concepts about such rhythm exercises in future lessons. We also will practice all the Sapta Talas and other Talas later on. Keep practicing the each of these individual gadis first, and it will take time before you can move on from one gadi to the next. So Tisram to Chadusram to Khandam to Misram to Sankirnam takes time, but keep practicing. I hope it has been useful. I look forward to seeing you again in my future lessons. Thank you for watching.